Greetings. This is a response to a hit piece I saw in Expressen earlier today. But before I begin to elaborate on that hit piece, I would just like to give an update on the Swedish metapolitical and political situation for my international audience. So, long story short, 10 years ago, if you said you supported the Sweden Democrats, that was a sure way to commit social suicide. I did. I have absolutely no regrets whatsoever, and I do think a lot of guys, in retrospect, they wish they would have taken a stand for what is right earlier as well. Now, 10 years later, however, if you say that you support the policies of the Sweden Democrats, it's not a big deal. You can still maintain your social network, you might even maintain your job. So it's not as big of a deal, and you know, in polls, they are coming either as the largest party or the second largest party or the third largest party. So the shift in the Overton window over this last decade, it is truly remarkable. So that is because of a simple reason. The majority of Swedes and non-Swedes have had enough of this madness that is going on. Enough of mass immigration, enough of unjust policies. It's not only to do with immigration, it's the injustice of it all. You know, you can have an immigrant who has worked and paid his taxes, and then for one little misstep in the formalia, he gets kicked out, and then you have, you know, all sorts of other people who are not doing any effort to fit in whatsoever. They get to, you know, stay, they get all the welfare in the world, etc. So it's a matter of right and wrong, no matter what your ideology is. You don't need to be an ethno-nationalist to see that something is horrendously wrong with Sweden. So anyway, that is the starting position. Now, these journalists who are still trying to portray guys like me as villains, they, you know, live in their bubble of other left-wing extremist journalists, so they haven't, you know, they haven't gone the same path as the rest of Sweden. They still believe in this madness, basically. And everyone who questions it is a heretic who needs to be labeled as such. In a recent video, I talked about witch hunts. It's alive and well in Sweden. It was worse 10 years ago, or even 20 years ago, but it still is there. And yeah, hit pieces like this is a good example. So I'm being accused of being a right-wing extremist. Yeah, had I been a woman living 400 years ago, I would have been accused of being a witch. It's the same thing, except that they won't burn me at the stake. They will just try to harass me, try to bully me, but you know, I've never backed down from these cowards, not once in my life. I won't back down now either. I suggest that you, if you're being targeted by these hyenas, don't back down. They will only smell weakness, they will come at you even more. So basically, the hit piece is on the Free Sweden project, the Fria Sverige, and the House of Swedes. And the Free Sweden is a project I've been participating in since its birth in 2017, and it's an interest organization for Swedes. The House of Swedes is a house where pro-Swedish individuals can gather and, you know, have social activities, have trainings, etc. And that also brings me into my role in this whole thing. I am responsible for health, fitness, self-defense, instructions, etc. And I can just say that in my seminars I've held, there has been all sorts of people. Last one I held before this whole corona thing blew up, I held a seminar where we had the youngest, a 16-year-old girl, and the oldest, a 70-somethings male. And now you might wonder, journalists, you can ask yourself, you can meditate a bit on this, why do all of these people come to get self-defense instructions from this extreme villain here? I can actually tell you it's quite simple, because they are feeling insecure because of the multicultural hell project you have helped create. That's why they want to learn self-defense. So you see youth gangs literally hunting down young Swedish schoolboys, robbing them, beating them, humiliating them. I won't go into further detail here, but you know the story. You also have sexual harassment of young girls, young women, and people are being fed up with it, and then you try to portray me as the villain. I try to teach people to defend themselves from the hell you have created. I try to speak up against the evil you have created, and then you want to label me as a villain. Do you understand how evil you are? When I walk down the street, in any of the big cities, there will always come up at least one guy telling me, keep up the good work. For you, as a journalist, do you have the same popular support? No, you don't, because people don't like you. That's simply the truth, because you have been lying to them for ages. I've been telling the truth, I'm trying to empower my people. That is why I am very popular, and you, journalist, you are hated. So maybe you should look yourself in the mirror and say, yeah, maybe I should try to change my ways, try to do something good for once instead of just lying about guys like me. Then also in the article, they said I'm a right-wing extremist who has held speeches at, again, right-wing extreme conferences in America, Ukraine and Holland. Yes, I have. Do you know what I talk about mainly? Self-improvement and fitness. Exactly the same sort of stuff I talk about on my channel. So if you want to make it all mysterious, you don't need to. You can just look through all of my videos on my channel and you can see exactly which position have I taken that is so extreme. And they also included a quote from an earlier Q&A where they quoted me in saying all humans aren't equal. Where is the lie? And the quote continues, it would be better for society if some men didn't exist. Where is the lie? Where is the purpose in having pedophiles and rapists in society? I don't understand. For anyone who's inclined to agree with the journalists, you can comment down below and let me know. Maybe you changed my mind. Maybe you can tell me why these men are being, why these men are being needed in society. So anyway, the Free Sweden Project, you know, all other ethnicities can have an interest organization for themselves. Why can't Swedish people have one? I don't understand. Why is it so horrible? Why is it so wrong? And why is it so horrible that I teach health and fitness? Isn't it good in this pandemic era? Isn't it good to have a better immune system because you are healthy? Isn't it good to feel more confident in a deteriorating society because you've been training self-defense? Or you've put on some muscle so you can feel better? So these are just questions you as a journalist can ask yourself. So that was my response, nothing really new, but you can check out the Free Sweden Project and Svenskarnas Hus, the House of Swedes, below. And also, a while ago I said I was to create Temple of Iron, a gym for pro-European individuals, and that is coming along just fine. There has been some delays due to the corona pandemic, but it's in the works at least, and it will be in the house. So then I will be very happy to teach men and women on how to lift weights properly to increase their confidence and their health. So stay tuned for that. So if you want to know more, if you want to support me or follow me on other social media, if you want to check out the House of Swedes, etc., check out all the links in the description box below. So thank you for watching. XOXO, boom.